Hey everybody, it's 41. Welcome back to Metroid Zero Mission. The last time we dispatched Ridley in a rather disappointing fight. So, upon exiting this area, we're going to be obtaining a few pickups along the way, which is nice. It's always nice. And run through this hall of enemies that just conveniently is sitting right there, begging for you to run into them. But, that's not all. Go right down here. And lo and behold, E-Tank. The third one in Ridley. And the final one in Ridley. So, this just leads us back to that one shaft on the right side. Remember, I'm not picking up that missile specifically because I am going to wait for the space jump, which will make life infinitely easier. Or so I hope. It's not exactly an easy one to get to begin with. But this is the way we're going to be exiting. It's a pretty straight shot, but first thing we're going to try to do is we're going to try to freeze that Zeb. Or, I'm not even sure what it's called. It's not a Zeb. I think Zebs are the ones in Brinstar. But either way, freeze that one enemy, get yourself a missile, and profit. But truthfully, that's the last thing to pick up here. We are going to exit. Also, a little note. You may like trying to attack those holtzes and do the pseudo-screw attack. It doesn't kill them outright. You'll actually take damage. Now, there's also bombable blocks up here, which leads to a dissolvable right there. I'm not exactly sure what the point is. I think it's a dissolvable right there, but I'll check. Oh, maybe I'll save it for another time. Either way, I would think at least it's something, but I never quite figured out what, if anything. It, for all I know, it could just be a way back. Which makes some sense, actually. Anyway. The game's pretty much invited you to go this way, and you'll notice that the statue got decapitated for some reason. Well then, that's pretty interesting. Now, there's a screw attack thing there, and of course you see a cannon right there. There's also a missile block right there, which leads to a cannon. Entering these will just send you back up to the right side of Norfair, and you really won't find much of note, I don't think. All told, kind of disappointment. And what you really want to do is you really want to head left. All the way to the left. And run through everything you see. Because you'll actually get a prize for doing this. Sorry, a new car was already taken. Can't afford that here at 40 Warrior Enterprises. No, the prize is a room full of Ripper 2s for some reason. Okay, that's not really much of a prize now, is it? Game will let me up, which I don't think it wants to for some bloody reason. There we go. You'll get the real prize here, and that is the ability to, well, screw attack things. So now we can really do damage while jumping into enemies every time. And let's just test it out right now. What do you guys think about this new screw attack I got? What do you think about the new shiny screw I got? That sounds horribly wrong. Why did I say that? I should be damned to hell for this! Or at least damned to a missile tank. What would that be like, my... I think it might be my 200th missile. Thinking about it. Either way, screw attacks mean you can just start jumping down and destroying things summarily. Which is good news. But, also gives us a license to go in here now. Couldn't go in here before because I... Whoa, Jesus H, game. Come on. That ain't right. What the heck? Alright, looks like it's normalized now. I'm not sure what the hell that was about. All I know is it's mad annoying to see that happen numerous times. Anyway. As soon as we tear through everything here... Well... We'll eventually go through here, this little hole. And sooner or later, I swear, feels like 90 years, we'll get to this shaft over here. Once again, fake lava. What else is new? But the tough thing is going to be two pickups, and one of them is rather difficult. One of them is rather easy. You start with these gemers, gemers or whatever they are, and you freeze one. Now, don't do a screw attack by accident. That would not be good for you. Screw attack up here is okay, though. But that's not all. Now you gotta hit on the rebound. And then do that. If you could somehow manage that, you get yourself both a super missile and a regular missile tank. So, congratulations. Not the easiest thing to do, but it is something. And I guess I deserved it for abusing that guy. But it also is your way to get out of here quickly. So, now that we did that, now you know exactly what was over here. And I'd say it's pretty well worth it, don't you agree? So with that in mind, there is another place that requires a super missile door. A super missile to open. Probably leads to something good. So, meet you over there. Shouldn't take very long because that vertical shaft all the way on the right that we've been using speed boost to go down, well, the way up is via screw tack. So, lucky you. So here we are at the shaft, and you see, we can destroy things rather easily. So, hip hip hooray for us, I guess. Anyway, this is the magic door to go in. You remember this room, I'm sure. You had a couple polyps, you had a couple dragon, you had a couple novas, and you also had this door right here, leading to an ultra-heated area that you can burst through. Well then, this might go well. This will definitely not go well. I have the screw attack. I shouldn't really shouldn't have the screw attack at this juncture because it's just gonna make things overly complicated. By which I mean I'll be taking a lot of lava baths. Really not good for your skin. Or anything else for that matter. Ah, hell with it, just storm through! We don't need no health anyway. And also I clearly missed an item there, I'll go back for it. The other challenge here is, well, you're gonna wanna do this. Detonate this. Try to be as quick as possible! Or fuck up and have to reset and do it again. Never seem to get that jump. It's like the game does not want to give me it. Unless, of course, you shortchange it, in which case, well, you suck. Then, you do it again. Like me. I didn't miss that one. That's for goddamn sure. That's the only other super missile tank here, so we got you got both of them already. So, door fear is almost complete, actually. By my count, I think we just need two more missile tanks. Anyway, there's a missile tank. So we're down to one remaining, I believe. And we can't get that one yet, so we're not gonna worry about that. In order to do that, you need to take lava baths, and it'll be a pretty painful lava bath, so you're gonna need to have something to help yourself with that. Meanwhile, enjoy more lava baths, because they are what I need right now. They're the rave or something. I'm not exactly sure. And remember, screw attack for the win. See? Now, honestly, we've done pretty much everything we can here right now, so let's just use this as an excuse to shine spark one more time through here in all our glory with 200 missiles. See, I thought I had 200. Turned out I was right. Also, screw attack blocks. Because now, with everything done here, we only have two places to go. We have one place to go. Torian! See that little area of criteria? We can't do anything about that yet. So, don't worry about that. Instead, Let's travel to Torian in style! Or I'll just meet you where the guardians are. The guardian heads, I should say. I guess that'll make them the figureheads. Here we are. As you see, open sesame. We should be proud. Because now we're gonna head to the center of it all and take down everything. But, oh yes, I forgot to mention, there may be Metroids here too. There may be a bunch of them. They may be sucking a space pirate dry. So yes, you gotta defeat Metroids, and they're as formidable as you'd expect. They also, surprisingly enough, don't stay frozen for long. That must be the space pirate we saw be an untimely demise, or maybe it's this guy. And of course the Rinkas are here too, because they're still asses. And here's our first Metroid. You see it pops up pretty quickly. You gotta get rid of them quickly though, because they do unfreeze mind-bogglingly quick. Luckily, they're not the brightest bulbs in the sky, so you can sort of take advantage of that. And I always try freezing Rinkas just so I don't have to deal with them ever. No penalty in just refreezing them if need be. Just do it if you need to. And honestly, with the way these Metroids are, you're gonna want to. And remember, never use a power bomb against these guys. I learned that from Super Metroid. Thankfully, you don't have power bombs, so crisis averted, I suppose. Thankfully, you shoot missiles rather quickly, so that helps. But I still don't enjoy this. I never enjoy fighting Metroids, which I guess is a good thing. If you're going to be the namesake of a franchise, you probably should be a pretty tough customer. And, well, that's what Metroids are. Tough customers, to say the least. That happens way more than it should. And I'm gonna be fucked! Let me... You can see where the little panic attacks start when they start getting multiple Metroids coming at you. Then it's like, pandemonium. I love that word. I think it's a perfectly apropos word for everything. Once again, if you get caught, use a bomb, get yourself out of there. Pretty standard tactics, if I do say so myself. Don't go down there yet, because I want to at least get to the save room. And just chill, breathe, and relax. Now, if the game really wanted to be a dick, remember, Super Metroid, if you direct ship, if you didn't have it up and running, some covens would come and try to ambush you. It'd be kind of interesting if a Metroid tried to ambush you here. I'm going to save it. No! That would not be good. Matter of fact, I think that would be downright tragic. Luckily, Metroids are very intelligent, my foot. They don't seem too intelligent here. Well, except for that one baby, and that was plot. I give that one to the writers. I always believe in freezing the Rinkas, because you never know. You never know. I mean, sometimes you just get an utter dumbass. And sometimes you get interrupted when you're trying to attack things, which is always the worst feeling ever. Particularly when you have multiple Metroids inbound. And then it's like, oh boy. You know, having a hot day with a Metroid's not exactly a fun-filled experience. I don't care how many missiles I waste, I just believe in firing. Hell or high water. And this is where Hell or High Water really is going to strike, because this, if you want to talk about pandemonium, go. There's an obscene amount of Metroids here. A number that I wouldn't want. And of course, I want to just pick them apart, because this is what I mean. It's like an obscene amount of Metroids here, and they just don't seem to take no for an answer. It's kind of like forced crap. Not exactly my thing. I don't like this at all. And oh yes, if you get caught here, which is very possible, and you bomb this, Oh, you go down again. I don't like it. Have you figured this out by now? I just simply don't like this area. I mean, come hell or high water, right? Come hell or high water, you gotta get through here, but... let's just say... Those look like great options right now, compared to Metroid-topia right there. Mercifully, that is the last true pain of a room to go in. Because no more Metroids. No more Metroids is a good thing. So, and let's go. This is a room that's strictly here just to build up your arsenal if you need it. And after dealing with Metroids, you may or may not. It really doesn't. It really is an unknown. Obviously, you have the Zebatites you gotta deal with, you know, those barriers you gotta blast. But, well, I found the green ones actually drop more stuff than the little orange ones. Even though they still look like Applejacks to me. Anyway, here we go. And I just don't buy. I just don't take give a fuck. I just fire. Remember, those barriers do come back, so you gotta just get rid of them and go. And then once you get up here, I try to take a little lax approach. Just a little bit, not much. I mean, you know, you can only go so far. Stay in the pocket, take a few shots if need be, but ultimately, it's all about trying to free yourself. And what you do, rain down everything you have. And of course, when you go down here, do a subterranean subterfuge, Mother Brain gets wise. Luckily, I got lucky there. The way I bounced. Eh. The Rinkas are always worse. The worst customers. Eh. Not so much the turrets. I really don't care about the turrets too much. But it is nice to see Mother Brain actually fighting back. I think that is a good touch. But, well, no match for the utter recklessness that was my fighting ability there. And then we got a bail. We have 2 minutes to do this, and that's a good thing because there are a ton of dissolvable blocks in the way. Now, usually I try hugging the sides. If you fall, you can at least get to a wall, and you can at least break your fall a little bit. You know, none's worse than going full off all the way with the descent. Only to find out you go all the way back to the bottom. We don't want that. Also, we're just gonna shoot that, because... Why the hell would there be a super missile drawer there anyway? I mean, it just seems like an odd touch. It's almost like they expect you to come back here. But there's no way! This place is gonna go kablooey. We know how this ends. The base goes boom, and we get out of there, and we are going to revel in our victory. And look, such a generous amount of time they gave us at the end of the day. 45 seconds is all it took me, 2 minutes. So, we did it. Base destroyed. Mother Brain destroyed. We do what we need to. We left a smoldering crater in our wake. Or did we? That ain't good. Timing of my escape couldn't have been worse. I was attacked by space pirates, left nearly defenseless, stripped of my power suit. All I have for protection, I'd rather use a mercy pistol. Infiltrating the space pirate mothership so hard may have been foolish, but I had no choice. Also, that ass. Could I survive long enough to escape? That's right! They added a whole new section of the game! And you get that rather useless emergency pistol, which can stun enemies when fully charged, and it charges rather quickly, thankfully. A few seconds. Also, somehow Samus retains her incredible jumping ability that is completely unnatural. But this whole thing is not clear to me. Stripped of her power suit implies that the pirates have something to do with this, but we all know the pirates did. Also, that's a power bomb's block. Interesting. It would imply that somehow the space pirates took it out, but we all know that she didn't lose it that way. She just simply, like, lost it at the end of the, at the end of the conflict. It's almost like it was a rental. I never quite understood the whole premise behind that. And for those people saying, well, isn't it supposed to be the mindset? I suppose, but it just doesn't feel like good timing to me. For me to believe that. Anyway, map room, thank goodness. We're definitely going to know where we need to go, that's for damn sure. Although, ironically, we started off in a hidden area. Now, even though it's the mothership, technically it's Chizodia, so interesting little tidbit for you there. But the Chozo ruins, I believe, are part of Criteria. Also interesting. Anyway, save rooms here thankfully fully heal you, and also recharge your weapons. We don't have any weapons other than the stupid pistol, but that's completely different. Anyway, I'm gonna stop the part right now. Next time, Solid Samus, I guess. Anyway, see you guys later. 40 Warriors signing off.